secrets to his people. So here God is at work and he's doing something fantastic in this world, and that is very, very important. And he doesn't want the secrets of his kingdom to be closed, but he wants to reveal those secrets to his people. When we can understand about the kingdom of God, then our lives will be changed totally, and we'll know the power of his kingdom. So when we know about Christ, and through Christ we can know what is going to happen in this world. So today again I felt like continuing how to know about his kingdom, and that is very, very important, because in the Gospels or in the Old Testament, everywhere we find about the truth of his kingdom. So God was keep reminding, and he's always wants to share about his kingdom. So even in Gospels we find many times Jesus, he mentioned about his kingdom, saying that when disciples, they asked Jesus how to pray, then he said, and he asked them to pray, "Let thy kingdom come." And the center point of our prayer should be the kingdom of God that should establish. So our prayer always, that should be focused to bring the rule of God in our lives, in our family, and in our country. Amen. So if we can understand the secret and the truth about his kingdom, then really our lives will be different. We'll enjoy to taste his kingdom, and also that can really help us to move powerfully in this world. There were some people who were received the revelation about the kingdom, and the revelation made them all together a different thing in their life. They were raised from pit to the heavenlies. Hallelujah. Today God is saying, and God wants to release his revelation about his kingdom to our lives. When we receive, then our eyes will be opened. God wants to open our eyes. Amen. And that is very, very important. Amen. So our life always, that will depend about the kingdom of God and the revelation of God. So based on that, one can live in this world successfully. Without having the revelation of God, then our lives in this world, that will be nominal, and that will surround only up to ourselves. Always we want to find ourselves comfortable, and we'll have many desires about our life, and we'll be keep thinking about our future, and we plan many things, and our minds will be filled only with our plans and purposes. But if you can know the kingdom of God, then our lives is going to change completely. Then our lives will be raised in a higher level. So we find one man of God, Daniel, how he could receive the revelation about the kingdom of God. So that really touched my life. Always when I go through about the secrets of the kingdom, it really strengthens me. Today that is going to strengthen all of us, and based on that, we are going to pray about that. So here in the book of Daniel, we can find King Nebuchadnezzar. He dreamt a dream, and then he forgot. Then he was asking his people and the wise men and others to give the meaning of the his dream. Then they came and asked the king. They said, "So you reveal your dream, then we are going to interpret your dream." And he was very angry, and he said he was not happy about that because king forgot. So king could not receive whatever that has shown in his dream, but that has revealed by the servant of God or by the child of God. So for this world, they may not receive the revelation about the kingdom of God. Their eyes are closed. But here, those who seek God, then God is going to open the secrets of his kingdom. Then when king decided to kill all the people who were like wise men who were in his court, then when Daniel, he heard about that, immediately he has taken permission and he prayed. Then something we see God, he could reveal to Daniel. So there we find in the book of second chapter, Daniel. And he and his friends, they prayed. So these friends, they were supporting Daniel by praying for this revelation. So when they were praying, they didn't know what the king has dreamt, but God has given the revelation. Here we find in the verse 27. Daniel answered in the presence of the king and said, "The secret which the king has demanded, the wise men, the astrologers, the magicians, and the soothsayers cannot declare to the king. But there is a God in heaven who reveals secrets, and he has made known to King Nebuchadnezzar what will be the later days. Your dream and the visions of your head upon your bed were this." And he started explaining about the dream. He said that was about a big image, a great image. This great image, whose splendor was excellent, stood before you, and its form was awesome. This immense head was of fine gold, its chest and arms of silver, its belly and thighs of bronze, its legs of iron, its feet partly of iron and partly of clay. You watched while a stone was cut out without hands, which struck the image on its feet of iron and clay and broke them in pieces. Then the iron, the clay, the bronze and silver and the gold were crushed together and became like chaff from the summer threshing floors. Amen. Here, that image that that was symbolic to different ruling or the kingdoms which are going to come, and the present kingdom also. And here he was explaining the meaning of the dream. This is the dream. You will tell the interpretation of it before the king. You, O king, are a king of kings, for the God of heaven was given you a kingdom, power, strength and glory. And wherever the children of men dwell, or the beasts of the field and the birds of the heaven, he has given them into your hand and has made you ruler over them all. You are this head of gold. So, at the time of that Babylon Empire, we see that was symbolic and it was showing the power and the excellency of his ruling as gold. And next to Nebuchadnezzar, that ruling that is going to be like silver and that is going to be divided. And later it will be like bronze, and then it will be like iron, and in the end it will be mixed kingdom, and it has some strengths and weak points together. And we see the quality of the ruling in this world and the ruling of the kingdom. We find from the stage of gold to that has going down and down, finally it will be very much weakened when the iron that has mixed with the like a clay, it won't be having any strength. It will be like a dividing kingdom. But there we find one thing that is going to happen, that is there one stone without stone was cut off without hands. So when the stone struck the feet of the image, immediately the whole thing crashed, and that stone started growing, and that has occupied the whole world. And the stone, whatever that has mentioned and shown, there we see all the kingdoms of this world that is going to end up, by the kingdom of God that is going to come up as a stone that has not taken by any, that not a work of any person in this world or a like a human being, but that has power, and that is going to curse the all other kingdoms. So that is symbolic to the kingdom of God, Jesus Christ. Amen. So when the dream has revealed great truth about God and the kingdom, immediately there we find the great change in the life of Daniel. So here we see Daniel from the beginning, he was obedient to God, and he was having the fear of God. So we should appreciate his parents, the way they have raised their child in the fear of God. That has resulted in this world to bring the truth of his kingdom to the people. Hallelujah. God could use Daniel to bring the revelation about his kingdom. Hallelujah. So when we receive that revelation, and really that is going to strengthen us and help us to live a fruitful life in this world. So in the life of Daniel, we find one thing. His mind totally concentrated on the purposes of God. In his like when he was in Judea, in Jerusalem, there he found the Babylon, and Babylonians, they came and invaded the nation, and they have taken all people who were all intelligent and who are capable, they have taken them captive to Babylon. And Daniel and Shadrach, Meshach, Abednego, they were also in that group. So in his eyes, he has seen the things what all happened in his nation. He could watch all those things in front of his eyes. His people were killed, and he was taken out from his parents. Though he left his place, and he has gone to a Chaldeans, and he learned that language. But here we find, though his nation, he has gone to another nation, living with other people, but his understanding about God, nothing could shake. Hallelujah. He was very strong and having the fear of God. That is very, very important. So when he was with the other co-students there, we see he was entirely different from other people. He decided himself not to worship any other thing apart from God. So always he was having that fear on God, and he dedicated his life for God at his early age. So as he was always open to God, when he wants please God, then certainly such person can receive the purpose what is lying on his life. There a time came, we see, so Daniel and others, they were all in everything, they were proved above everything. So when Daniel, he was given a great place in the kingdom, there we see a great challenge came. So because he was open to God, he knew God, then he was saved from the people who were slaughtered by the king. So he could come out and he could escape from the king's hands. And there something happened. When they prayed for the dream, what king has dreamt, there God has revealed this truth. There, when he has revealed that truth, immediately they will see Daniel and his friends were promoted, and they were all rewarded by king. And also we see in the life of Daniel, he was kept praying for a establishment and rebuilding of his nation and the temple. So while praying, he used to open the windows on the side of Jerusalem, and he used to lift his hands, and he kept praying for the rebuilding of the temple of God. Hallelujah. He was praying. Here I want to say one thing: whoever they are focused, then certainly we see whatever they are focusing, that can be established only by interceding in the presence of God. In other way, I can say intercession, that's not a small thing. That's a very important task what God, he wants us to accomplish some of the things through prayer. So intercessor here, we have to we can say those who have, or else we can say those who are focused, they're the people, they can intercede for the things to be established. Hallelujah. So for his life, he was totally focused on one thing. Though he had other business and he had his own life, everything, but his focus of his life, that was to see the rebuilding of the temple of God. So he was always, he was praying to see that happen, and to see his whatever the goal he has, that to be established. So when he was praying, then that prayer that has given the revelation and what is going to happen. Hallelujah. So we should surrender our life to the thing what God has shown us, and we should not change our purpose or like we cannot have our own understanding or our aim about intercession, but always there should be a like important our focus to the thing what God has shown, that is very, very important. Hallelujah. Very, very important. So whatever we pray, that is different, but our focus is where what we are focusing, that is very, very important. We should not live till we live in this world. So Daniel, he was like that, and he's a good example for for the intercession. So as intercessors, we should know, we should be always focused. We should have a life focused, and we should not be dragged away from the things of this world. Many times our focus that will always will be captured by the problems around us, about us, about our our jobs, our career, our studies, about family, all things that usually makes us to divert from our focus. So this evening, we should make a decision to focus ourselves on the vision what God has given us. So we can say what we are focusing, that is the vision. Here we see the vision what Daniel had, that that he was constantly praying that to happen and to establish, that was the rebuilding of the temple of God. So while praying in the presence of God, we see during that time God raised Nehemiah and Ezra and others, and Nehemiah, he could go to Jerusalem and emperor also, he was helping Nehemiah to build a temple. So we read all that in the book of Nehemiah. So when a person there in Babylon, when he was praying, then God is moving things according to the prayer what the intercessor he was praying. Hallelujah. Amen. So intercession, that is always powerful, and that is going to move towards the goal of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So our intercession, our time spending with God, that is very, very important. In other way, we can say that's a royal responsibility. That is why in 1 Peter 2:9 we see that we are all royal priests. Hallelujah. So royal priests are always meant for royal work, kingdom job. And we will find what the kingdom that has established here in the book of Daniel. Here we see when Daniel was praying, and his heart was so much a burden for the prophecy that was brought by prophet Jeremiah. So he found that for prophecy about the nation of Israel and Jerusalem. So here we find in 9th chapter, verse 2. I will read one part of the verse. The word of the Lord through Jeremiah the prophet, that he would accomplish 70 years in the desolations of Jerusalem. So when the Jerusalem left desolate, there we find that is going to rebuild, and that was prophesied by the prophet Jeremiah. So our intercession always, there should be based on the word. So whatever God has spoke through His word, we should focus on the word what God has spoken. So that word caught hold of Daniel, and he didn't leave that verse, and he caught hold of that verse and kept interceding in the presence of God, and he has that heart to see his nation and the Jerusalem to be rebuilt. They were all they were thrown and pulled out, everything spoiled, and that gave him a great agony about Jerusalem. Are we having that agony about our nation? How much agony we are carrying? We are just having the like a burden only up to ourselves, and we are not able to cross our personal thing to the desires of God. So if a person, he is sick, whatever God he wants to establish, then we'll find such life always that will be in the kingdom level, that will be raised as a royal level. Hallelujah. That is what we see when Daniel, he was focusing himself about Jerusalem. There we find God was blessing Daniel and kept him and given him a higher place. Actually, he was supposed to be in a lower state, because he was brought as a captive. He was not supposed to have freedom and not to give any position in that kingdom. But there we find the person who was focused, let us repeat that word, a person focused, always he will be in a upper level. Hallelujah. So here the intercession, what he was doing, there we find he was dealing with the kingdom of this darkness. So that intercession always that will fight with the darkness, dark powers, and the light of the Lord that is going to shine upon this land. Hallelujah. As he was interceding, we find he fasted for 21 days to get the answer from God. Many times I see many, they want to follow the same like Daniel, and they fast for 20 days and 40 days. And those who fast, I feel like crying. There won't be any focus about their fasting and to gain something. Always when you fast and prayer, there should be a right thing before you to gain. Without a target or a aim, it's not good to fast much. Just for our strength or for spiritual strength, one day of the week, that is enough. But I found people, they were fasting every year 40 days. Though they fast 40 days, later I found, in the beginning I thought, oh, I used to admire looking at them, and I used to think, oh, these people, they fasted 40 days. What a power they are going to, and the power is going to manifest in a powerful way. And finally I used to find I had to pray for them. Then I found why they are so weak after fasting 40 days. What they could gain? Nothing. Sometimes for small things, they pray so much, they use their strength and struggle for small things. They will pray such a prayers and fast, but that looks like If you want to throw a small stone, if we call a big crane, how it will be? We can just lift that stone with our hands and we can throw off. If we call a big crane, even that crane can't fit and it can't be removed. So always when you pray, you should find your expectation, what to pray. Hallelujah. When you seek the kingdom of God and all these things, seek ye first the kingdom of God and all these things will be added unto you. Hallelujah. When Daniel was seeking the kingdom of God, there we see all the things they were adding. He got the great, highest position in the kingdom, in entire, in the kingdom. And also, he had everything. He was enjoying his life. So, some people, if they are given some blessings, they think that's enough and they will be satisfied for themselves. But here Daniel, though he was given all comforts and luxuries and position and money, everything he was holding, but his mind completely focused on the God's purpose. So here God is seeking something through our lives. We should be the people of focused. We should be focused people. We should be focused. And you might have read that book, we should be like purpose driven life. We should be driven by the, or we should be drove by the vision. We should be having a purpose on our lives. Hallelujah. That is the strength of our life. The purpose, what God has about our lives, that is our life. If you are not able to focus yourself about on God, on what God has for you, then the life what you are leading in this world, that is all waste. That is what we see in many places. God said, our lives should be rooted in the purposes of God. Hallelujah. In Psalm 1 also we see, those who meditate the word of God day and night, they will be like planted in the shore of the river, river and streams of the growing and strong, and they will bear fruit. Hallelujah. We should be rooted in God. We should be rooted in God. Hallelujah. So, even we see in Isaiah 11, I think, about the root. Isaiah 11th chapter. First verse, there shall come forth a rod from the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. Hallelujah. Do you know what it is? And the there shall come forth a rod from the stem of Jesse, and the stem that was left, and the kingdom of God that has not revealed to the people, there we find a rod, or the shoot is coming up out of the tree, and that is the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And roots always, that is kingdom of God. And the kingdom should be like this would be sprouted up. It is the chicken and chicken.
But
this should
sprout.
Sprout. that should have the beginning, that life should start growing from the dead one. Hallelujah. There is no like bud or the sprout in that dried stem, but God was promising about the king or the person of the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. That is showing that God is going to send a kingdom man to this world. So whatever God has promised to the person Jesse, father of David, there we find the root that is symbolic to Jesus. And when here Daniel noticed the prophecy, there we find he started praying again and again, again and again. Then we know the answer of his prayer, and the angel came to him. But he didn't stop his prayer. He would have stopped when he received his answer by first day, he wouldn't have continued. So, because he had to continue his intercession or prayer, he didn't receive the answer. So he had to pray and pray and pray and pray. On 21st day, there we find the angel brought the answer for his prayer. And God revealed the truth about that 70 weeks prophecy, about the restoration of the kingdom of God or the Jerusalem. Hallelujah. So that's a very big subject to explain about 70 weeks. That is still we can count. That's a pictorial thing that has given in the prophecy. So when Daniel was praying, there we find God has shown how he is going to fulfill his prophecy. Hallelujah. So when God, he releases prophecy upon our lives, we should not forget, and we should keep praying about that. Hallelujah. And always we are pulled out to pray for other things than the like important thing what God has given us. So only when we have an aim, then we'll be the people of focused. Hallelujah. For such people we can call visionaries. Visionaries. Here each one of us, God, he wants us to be visionaries. Visionaries will have a vision what God is going to accomplish in this world. That is what we find in the life of Daniel. He had a vision about the kingdom of God, which is going to take place and occupy the whole world, because this whole creation belongs to God. And here, when man, he disobeyed God, he lost his place of authority. But when Jesus, he came to this world as a man, he restored back the authority to a man. As a man, he taken back the authority. Because he has authority over all the earth, then he had to sit on the throne. From there, he wants to rule there, rule this world. So here really we see we are all privileged. I want to tell why. There Daniel, he was he got a revelation about the kingdom. Here we can live in the revelation. Hallelujah. And these days also, if you feel that God is going to do something later, no, these are the days of his kingdom. And the rule that should be come upon this land through his church, through his body. So when we talk about the church, That's not a small thing. Church, that is his body of authority to bring ruling over this land. So, we should receive that vision about his kingdom. That is very, very important. If you can receive that vision, if your mind has opened to know about the vision of kingdom, that will give you that fire. You will be on fire. You will be on fire. When we sang that song, we are going to sing that one. There we see, our heart should see, we should have that thirst and hunger to see the kingdom of God being established in this world. So, as Daniel, as an intercessor, he prayed, we are all supposed to pray for the establishment of his kingdom. So, Daniel was having that vision about the future. And we are here, we are present in that vision. Amen. Amen. So we are tasting the kingdom of God. So how one can enter into his kingdom? That we see in Mark 1:15 says, the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent and believe. And believe the gospel. Hallelujah. Repent. Repentance means, that is like making a decision to obey God. Whatever we are, and we should turning back from the present thing and coming under his ruling. So here church should represent the ruling of God or the kingdom of God. Many, they are just interested to achieve something for their own lives, but they are not interested to live in the kingdom of Lord. They don't want to involve themselves in the kingdom of God. No need to worry about a big number. If they are not having the vision and they are not obeyed, they are not obedient to his kingdom, and if they are not having the kingdom understanding, then that will be like a religion. Having some rituals and our methods of religious activities. Always we'll be happy to have different activities in the church. More than that, that kingdom that should hold the church, that is very, very important. And we should not that is not our problem to think about who is our leader or who are going to attend the church. That is not important. But that kingdom that can be established by the obedient people, when we hear the word of God, then we should obey ourselves to God's purpose, and we can come together as a church. Then that is the strength of the kingdom that is going to work against the kingdom of this darkness. Hallelujah. So when the kingdom of God establishes, and we see, the kingdom of darkness will flee. Hallelujah. And really, I feel that is my heart. Always I feel burdened about the kingdom of God. When I back home, when I look at the people in my church, and when they are not able to understand about the kingdom, then I will cry for such people. I want to see people receiving that revelation about the kingdom. So intercessor means he will have a goal and keep praying and focusing on that point till he achieves. Hallelujah. So here we find Daniel invested his life for the thing what he was focusing. Hallelujah. In other way, we can say he laid his life for that vision. He was enjoying his life. Don't think that if we focus ourselves to the vision, that may not give us any pleasure. That will give us great joy. We lack nothing. All our needs will be met by God. He's going to take care about our wealth and health and our future, everything. So we should see people, they are taking the vision and the burden of this kingdom, and if they can pray, then certainly then God is going to bring forth his ruling upon our country. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And even in the Old Testament we find Queen Esther, she though she was a queen there, she has taken up that ark for her nation. So as a young girl, she would have had many dreams and many temptations around her, but she was so faithful to her uncle, and also we see she was growing in the fear of God. Then God could use her for his purpose. She was very beautiful, and though she didn't have parents, these days we find children, though they have parents, they are so disobedient, arrogant, and always they want to choose their own way of life. But here Esther, though she didn't have parents, she raised in the fear of God that made her life to be blessed. Hallelujah. Not only her life, brought great blessing to the whole nation. Otherwise, the Israelites would have vanished. But God used her. God wants to use you. Hallelujah. When she started interceding for her people, then God could manifest in a mighty way to deliver the nation of Israel. Here, we are in a need in this end days. Here, God, he wants his church to rise up and to have a focused life so that the enemy will be crushed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So let us pray for our nation and for the establishment of his kingdom. Only by the people who will receive that vision. God wants to reveal things, what he is going to accomplish. Do you have anything to see, to be established in this world? So I have my calling, for example. That is my goal to achieve. As the God's choice for woman, God's choice for revival, I got that title not on my own. God, he sent me and asked me to read one book on my birthday. I was expecting some word from God. I didn't get any word till I woke up in the morning. I was very much depressed. Every day I get the word that I didn't get any word. I went and sat in the church in one of the cities in Andhra. There, that day, I had to take some meeting. After my meeting, then, before that, pastor of the church came and handed over one book, Streams in the Desert, and said, Sister, our church history is written in this book. One of the day, that is Streams in the Desert, you know, no? That is a daily reading of the devotions. So he showed that page and he went off. After finishing my class and I gone to a room, I prayed and I asked God to speak to me and to give a word for my birthday. Yeah, on birth rest will be very serious to get about than other ways. So, I thought first, I thought of reading that devotional book. Later I thought I should read Bible. So in that I found that John 14 verse 13, it says, whatever you ask in the name of Jesus, he's going to give you to glorify the name of Father. So that is what giving the gist. So on the based on that verse, there was a history written in that passage saying one couple from UK, they have gone to that place, Ongole. Some of the people here, they know. So they worked very hard for 7 years. Finally, they could lead only one old lady, 8-year-old lady, to the Lord. They were very much depressed and they decided to pray for the Ongole. So they took the took that lady along with them and they started praying, three of them, on a mountain top. While praying on the third day, that missionary saw a vision, a mission church, mission hospital and a school. Then he started jumping and they praised God. God answered their prayer. After going back, what happened, you know? God sent a man, God's choice for revival. When we arrived, then great revival came and many started taking baptisms and the church built. And so when singing, all of a sudden God said, I'm going to use you like that. As a woman, God's choice for revival. That is my like word for your birthday. Lord, this is not good. It's not finding good. I said, give me some other thing. Then God said, whatever I give, you should take. Because I couldn't understand what it is. And I thought that is impossible. So in the Bible, I had to write down, because after, as I was praying, I heard a knock and the pastor, he arranged a car to take us to that mountain. And he was showing where they prayed, how the church and other things came up and the direction where they prayed and God showed the vision that has come up. And while pastor was explaining me, there God was speaking to me and said, see, when people they pray, what happened? If you pray, I'm going to do something. Hallelujah. Here this evening, God is saying, if you pray, then God, he is going to do something. Prayer activates God. And he's going to move powerfully. Hallelujah. Through you. Let us speak to ourselves. Through me. We have failed to pray whatever God has spoken to us. So what happened, being a woman, I wrote in that passage in a small letter. I didn't want anyone to watch that. The woman God says, it happened in the month of November. I prayed. December I prayed. January we had a conference in our church and Reverend Alan Vincent, he came from USA. While the praise and worship was going on, in the middle of the song, he came on the stage and he said, stop! Here, God is asking us to pray on one word, that is, whatever you ask in my name, that I will do, that the Father may be glorified in the Son. So, now you ask, what is going to glorify God? That you can ask. So now you think about how to glorify God by asking something. So I was also thinking, I was counting myself, what shall I ask? Shall I ask India? Immediately I was getting that word, the woman God says for revival. No. What shall I ask? Shall I ask Asia? No, the woman God says for revival. That's not good. How it will happen? I don't want that. So, like that, I was avoiding the word. Finally, Reverend Alan Vincent, he said, now, whatever you have decided or shown by God, you ask. So I thought of asking something, but my tongue turned and came out saying, the Lord make me as the woman God's choice for revival. I thought, why I'm praying? So from the stage, man of God said, now, do you believe what you have prayed is going to come true? I had to say yes, because I prayed. So no one knows what I prayed, what God spoke to me. That's a secret. So later, in the month of October, there, Science Fellowship, they asked me to come for full time. Then I thought I might say no. But God said, whatever I spoke to you about the stadium and other things, you are expecting that to happen in the organization of Christian education, CFE. But that is meant only for the Christian education. If you want to go beyond that, that is rebelliousness, God said. I was shocked because I was very much interested in gospel work. Already I raised some groups in the city. I was shocked. Then God said, then I asked, then where can I work? Whatever, where that can be established. Then God asked me to go to Science Fellowship. I felt, okay, Lord. Then I've taken an appointment for the Sunday. And Saturday I was praying in my room, what to speak to the founder of Science Fellowship, I have to speak. So I'm a little bit tensed about what to speak to the man of God. We're not so free to speak to him. Then while praying, God said, when you see the man of God, then you should say, the woman God's choice for revival has come. Huh? What? What, Lord? What do you think? If I am just a newcomer, can I go and talk to such a person, this word? Then God was angry and said, do you take so easy about the souls? When I have given the responsibility about the souls, and God said one thing, whatever I give, and he explained in a flash about the prayer warrior. He said, prayer warrior means a prayer warrior will take the word from God and keep praying about that. And that time when God says to go and confess that word to the person, to the right person, and that word is going to work as a bomb on the kingdom of Satan. I was shocked. Whole night I was shivering. I was not sure because I had to obey. Otherwise, God said, you will lose it. I don't want to lose that. When God has a purpose, either we have to fit in his purpose, either we have to lose. What would be the easy thing? Do you want to lose God's purpose on your life? Do you want to lose?
No.
Do you want to lose?
No.
What would be the good thing you can do?
Fit in the purpose.
To live in his purpose.
Amen.
Do you agree with that?
Yes.
Do you live in the purpose?
Yes.
To live in his purpose, maybe that won't be so interesting. That may not be attractive. That may not be profitable. That may not be so easy. Just in a distance where you can immediately go and do your job. But when God asked me to do that, next day I felt my finger that was on the trigger. The moment I speak that word, and then I'm going to gain so many souls. I've gone, and Pastor John Babu, he came out, and I had to say, the woman God's choice for revival has come. He was not surprised about what I said. He kept just note down on the diary. So then I had to explain what all God showed me. Then they asked me when you are going to join. Then I said I have to give 2 months notice and then I'll resign and I'll come. So like that I have joined Science Fellowship. But after joining the Science Fellowship, I can say that's not a very easy thing. That's very far. But for God's sake, for the purpose of God, even I can go if the distance, if it is double also, I'm ready to go. Because losing the purpose of God on my life only because of distance, that is really a foolish thing. I know that. And my parents were not happy. And like that, I didn't have any proper place. I was going, I had many problems, but I didn't want to lose the purpose, what is on my life. I caught hold of the purpose. I'm a purpose-driven woman. Hallelujah. I want to live as a purpose-driven woman. And I want to live as a kingdom woman. And I want to see the kingdom manifest in a powerful way. Amen. Hallelujah. Till then, I want to keep praying. Amen. In other sense, I can say, even God has reminded me about my prayer should be focused. I'm praying several things. Whatever that is demanding me, I'm praying about those things. Mainly, when we are in trouble, our prayer life always will be focused on the problems. Hallelujah. So, we should allow the kingdom of God to rule in our lives. First thing, that is going to start with our own life. And that is very, very important to have a vision. And even we see about Abraham, he had a vision and he was, in Hebrew 11 we find, Abraham was a greatest visionary, Abraham and Sarah. By faith, Abraham obeyed when he was called to go out to the place which he would receive as an inheritance. And he went out, not knowing where he was going. By faith, he dwelt in the land of promise as in a foreign country, dwelling in tents with Isaac and Jacob, the heirs with him of the same promise. For he waited for the city which has foundations, whose builder and maker is God. Hallelujah. That shows the kingdom of God. So here, he had a vision. God always, he expects us to see what he is looking about our lives. When he look at us, he see to establish his purpose through our life. That is what we see about God. And ourselves, we are supposed to see what God is seeing about ourselves. Then we can accomplish. But God will look at us in a direction. But our focus will be different. Then there won't be any coordination. How much we pray or how much we do, then nothing will happen. So, more than our problems, more than our needs, I can say our first priority is the kingdom of God. If you can accept His ruling over your life, if you are ready to obey Him, then certainly you will find the purpose being established through our lives. And tomorrow we are going to see the vision of God wants to establish through our lives and how the life of Jesus that is showing the level of kingdom how he led the kingdom life. So let us pray. And after the prayer, again I want to sing that song. Come set your rule and reign in our hearts again. Hallelujah. Let's pray. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. One thing I want to tell, always enemy is not happy about the kingdom of God. He doesn't want people to receive and to understand about his kingdom. So I feel we should pray have a intercessory prayers even tomorrow also. Then when we pray, certainly God will give that revelation. Revelation can be received by our spirits, not by mind. Mind can't receive. Mind can't understand. But within our spirits, we will receive the vision. Let's pray. Let us decide ourselves about our focus. Focus on what God gave you. You want us to understand your vision, Lord. And Lord, thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Each one of us here, we want to submit ourselves to you. Whatever that is hindering our lives, and not Rodrushya, opposing by the enemy. We break that in Jesus. Receiving Jesus. Receiving Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Let us sing. Hallelujah. Enemy that is trying to Krudrishya, to release the vision of kingdom. We break that in Jesus' name. That enemy should be crushed under our feet. Whatever that is binding the minds of the people here, and we command that to be loosened, and we command the eyes should be open to understand about the kingdom, about the heart of your law. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hello, Shikara. Establish as a church, as your kingdom law. Lord, let the kingdom that should come ruling our lives, Lord. Lord, we accept your ruling upon our lives, and we accept your ruling on our countries, Lord. Victory, victory, says the Lord. Lord, anoint this church, Lord. Anoint the Lord, Pastor Vijay, Pastor Sureka, and all the leaders and all the church members here, Lord. Lord, raise us up, Pastor, your kingdom. And Lord, as you said, nothing is going to stand before your church, Lord. And Lord, you are going to make things upside down, Lord. And the gates of hell shall not prevail. Against the church, the victory, says the Lord. Victory, says the Lord. You are the one, the Lord, winning the church. And Lord, those who have received the vision about the Lord kingdom, Lord, as we have joined together, Lord, that understanding that should give us unity and to Lord live, Lord, for you, Lord. We want to live powerfully for you, Lord. And we want to demonstrate the power of your kingdom, Lord. And we want to see the enemy should be crushed under our feet. Kingdom of God is near. Kingdom of God is near. Lord, raise kingdom people. And Lord, raise people to intercede in your presence for your kingdom, Lord. And Lord, give them, Lord, give us your vision to accomplish, Lord. Not our will, Lord, but we want your vision to be accomplished. Hallelujah. Lord, though we are, Lord, small in number, Lord, but we want people who are understanding about the vision, Lord, about your kingdom, Lord. Bless each one of us, Lord. Let your hand be upon the people. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I'm happy to see all visionaries here.